Hi, I'm Adam.
And I'm Caitlin.
In this video, we're going to be talking all about how you can use the Xbox Accessories app to customize your Xbox Adaptive Controller beyond the simple plug-and-play approach of connecting buttons and joysticks through the controller's ports. Specifically, we'll talk about how to use the Xbox Accessories app, how the app allows you to create profiles, what profiles are, and common troubleshooting tips while navigating through the process.
Customization with the Xbox Accessories app.
First, it's important to note that the Accessories app is available on both PC and Xbox console, so be sure to check out our linked support article for instructions on how to download the PC app. In this video, we'll take you through navigating the Xbox Accessories app on console, but once you are in the app itself, the experiences on PC and console are pretty much the same. Really, the only differences to note is that if you are remapping your controller on a PC, you must have your adaptive controller hardwired in terms of connection to your PC. But back to console. You can navigate to the Accessories app by pressing the Nexus or the Big X button on either your standard controller or your adaptive controller as well. Here you'll find your settings menu. You can navigate over to the Profile and System tab and then go down and select Settings. Here, you can navigate to the Devices and Connections option and then choose Accessories. This will launch your Xbox Accessories app. When you have your Xbox Adaptive Controller connected to your console, either wirelessly or through a wired connection, again, it doesn't matter for console, a picture of it will be displayed in the app alongside options like Configure, More Options, which looks like three dots, the Learn More button, and the Test Mode button. In order to create a remap profile, you're going to select the Configure option for the Adaptive Controller.
So, what is a profile? A profile is essentially a way to remap the button assignments or the port assignments on your controller to differ from the default assignments that are indicated by the printed labels on the device itself. You can then save that remapped configuration and then use it anytime you'd like. For example, let's say I'm playing a game like Forza Horizon and I want to use the two large buttons on the adaptive controller as gas and brake. In this game, the right and left trigger buttons on a standard controller are usually how you accelerate and brake your car. However, on the adaptive controller, the two large buttons are mapped to A and B by default. So I want to remap those to the right and left trigger. So in the Accessories app, I can select Add New Profile. And then you can choose a name for it. So in this case, I'm going to name it Forza. And then after you name it, you'll be brought into this user interface where you can choose which buttons to remap. So let's select the large A button. And then you get this menu. And under primary, I'm going to change it to the left trigger. And primary means the primary function of this button. So I'll choose left trigger from this button list. And then press B to back out of that menu, and then it saves. And you can see the updated mapping right below the left big button that used to be A, now it's LT. Next, I'll go over to B, select that, open the menu, go to the primary function, and this time do right trigger. And again, when I back out of this menu with B, it will save, and the updated mapping will appear right there.
And one important troubleshooting tip to keep in mind is that you always need an A button and a B button assigned in order to save your profile. So if I try to back out now where we don't have an A or B button because Adam just reassigned them, it reminds me, hey, the A button needs to be mapped, and it'll also do the same for the B. So what I'm gonna do here is choose a different port or button that I'm not using for something else. So a good option for this is usually the X1 and X2 ports, as those were intentionally made as sort of wildcard ports to assign them to whatever you'd like without taking the function away from another button. So on the remapping UI, they're called left stick up and left stick down. So I'm going to select left stick up, and under the primary function for X1 button, I'm just going to assign it to A. And then I'm going to do the same for X2 and assign it to B. So now I have a dedicated A and B button. And when I do back out of this interface using my B button, it'll save the profile for me. And as we mentioned, you're not limited to remapping just these two large buttons. You can remap any of the button or port functions on here to whatever you'd like.
So why use a profile? There are a few reasons we've seen players opt to use the Xbox Accessories app to create remapping profiles as opposed to using the default port assignments alone. This includes players who want to remap the physical buttons on the adaptive controller to something else, like Caitlin just described. It's also great for players who prefer to have different physical button setups for different games. For example, when I play Forza, I may want a specific button mounted near my head to be A. But then when I switch over to a shooter game, I might want that same physical button to function as X instead to fire my weapon. Instead of having to physically unplug this button and move it to a different port or different space between games, I can simply assign a different remapping profile that changes this physical button's function from A to X through software without having to physically manipulate my setup in any way.
So you mentioned being able to easily switch between the active profile or mapping on your device depending on what game you're playing. How exactly does that work?
Great question. So once you have some profiles saved, you can assign them to one of three active profile slots. So let's say I plan on using my Forza setup, my Minecraft setup, and my Halo Infinite setup during this particular play session. So I'm going to first select Forza, and then that's going to bring me to this drop-down menu that right now says no slot because it's not yet assigned to a slot. I'm going to go into this drop-down menu, and I'm going to assign Forza to slot one. And then now that moves Forza up in the list to the top of those three profile slots above on this left-hand side of the interface. I will do the same for Halo. I'll go into it, change it from no slot to slot two, and then I'll go to Minecraft and assign it to slot three. It's also important to note that you don't need to have any profiles assigned to your device. Using it in its default mode is totally fine. But if you do have profiles assigned and you want to know which of the three profiles is active on your device, you can take a look at the three profile indicator lights on the device itself. They're on the left-hand side of the controller. If none of the slots are lit up, that means that there's no active profile. That just means the controller buttons and the ports will function with their default mappings. If I want to activate profile one, I can press the change profile button and the top indicator slot light will light up, confirming that my controller is functioning with my first profile, in this case, Forza. And you can continue to press the switch profile button until your desired profile is active.
Those three profiles that you just stored in slots one, two, and three will save onto the device itself. So I can then take my controller, bring it over to my friend's house. I don't need to sign into my Xbox account to get those profiles. I just need to connect this device to their Xbox, and those remapping profiles will actually be saved right on the device.
You can save and create as many remapping profiles as you like. You're just limited to having three profiles at the same time physically stored on your controller.